What's up, guys? Hella Bucky here. Got a quick video for you. Today what we're going to do is we're going to kind of go over the electric paint sprayer that I got on Amazon that I'm going to be using to spray paint the Chevelle with the Satin Black Rust-Oleum. So there's three different tips that come with the sprayer. I'm going to be using the smallest one to start out with and move up from there. We'll do a couple test sprays and see which one works best. So the smallest one is in there now. Take a look here. This is how you change the field of spray, is moving that up and down. We're going to take that off real quick so we can see the guts here. So here's where you have your sprayer. So this part comes off, and each one of these is meant for, they're meant to go together. You can't mix and match between the orifices and the little tips. So you have to match those up. Again, this is the smallest one that's in there. You take this out of here. I couldn't find a wrench small enough, so we're just using the adjustable. It started like that, and then it unscrews. So let me get this put together, and we'll mix up some paint. According to Rust-Oleum directions, they want 15%. 15% ratio to thinning to get it to where it'll spray well. So we'll try to get to there. Did a little research and found a little trick for determining when it's the right thickness, and we'll play around with that. And so the brightness was pretty bad in my last video, so let me give you a better look at this so you can kind of get an idea of what's going on. So this is the smallest tip that's in there, and the little adjustment knob is on, so we could take that off, and then we could see the smallest tip on there. And if we look real close, we can kind of see how it works. See, each of these tips is matched up to that orifice. If you tried to use a larger or a smaller one, it probably would not flow at all, or it would flow too much. So here's the two bigger ones. It's the medium size one and the medium size tip, and the largest one with the largest tip. Now these guns, they're designed for like spraying household paint, which is considerably thicker than what we're going to be working with. So that's why the rationale behind trying the smallest one first. So let's get it mixed up.
We'll get a test spray done.
Okay, so I did some quick math, and we're going to be using the 6-to-1 calculation. It's based on the 15% that Rust-Oleum recommends. Take 100 divided by 15, and you got 6 2/3. So that should be money. I'm probably gonna do, this is the 8-ounce reading. So we'll go ahead and use that. I tried the little trick where you put the tape on there to keep it from getting all over the side. Let's see if that works. Well, that's a helpful little trick. Not perfect. We got some runners, but that's okay. All in all, a success. Okay. So now we go up to
line two right there.
With what we're using for thinner, aka our acetone. Stirring, I got the chocolate chip.
Okay, so I did a little mixing on that. It's coming around nice. Here's the trick I heard about for how to determine if you're at the right. So what you do is you watch the drips. You want drips after 3 seconds. So it'll be a steady stream and then drips after about 3 seconds. So just watch the end of the chopstick here. We should get about 3 seconds of steady flow, then drips. One, 2, 3 quarters. We'll give it 3. That's just fine. Alright. So here's what we're going to use for our test panel. This is the inside of my trunk. I'll be cleaning this up and spraying it at a later time. Maybe some bed line or something like that. We are kind of outside. I'm in my garage, but it's not too windy. It's not too bad. Really, we just want to play with the gun a little bit and get some tests done and see what setting it likes. We want that nice football shaped spray pattern, and we don't want it to run too much. Get the paint in there mixed up nice. Let's see what we got. So, definitely a small pattern, but the shape is actually pretty nice. Maybe I just need to run this nut in a little more so we get a little bit more flow, or maybe I need to switch to the medium tip. I'm going to try running this all the way wide open and see what we got. Okay, so this is how it turned out. Not too bad, but I believe I'm gonna step up to the mid-size tip instead of the smallest one. I feel like it just wasn't shooting very, it wasn't shooting enough. It was getting really, real speckly. So, not a bad result. There is orange peel in there, but it wasn't going to happen anyway. I didn't even prep the surface, really. I just rubbed it down with some acetone and just kind of vacuumed out the trunk. If it's going to turn out like that, I'm pretty happy with that. Once it dries, it'll be a little bit more satiny, and that's the look I'm going for. So, we're in good shape. Man, oh man, look at how well these turned out. I'm super happy with these. These are the rear wheels, the deep concave. It's a bronze metallic. I think it's going to look really nice contrasted with the satin black finish once I get it painted. Really happy with it. So this is approximately what the color is going to look like right there.